sugar lumps. What's up, everybody? Welcome to HQ Trivia. I'm your host with the most, holding it down from coast to coast. Smooth as the butter that you put on your toast. The one, the only, Money Flipping Matt Rich, a.k.a. Matt Was Funny. And tonight is Grammy night, babies. Grammy trivia. Hey, hey. Like it like that. I said I like it like that. I like it like that. Okay. No. Ariana will not be performing tonight on HQ, but some of the questions tonight are going to be based on video clips, so you're going to want to turn your sound up and get your focus on so you don't miss anything, okay? I don't want you to miss nothing. If you've played before, you know what's up. Tonight, I'm going to give you 15 questions. They start out easy, but they get harder than trying to hit one of them Mariah Carey whistle notes. You got 10 seconds to tap the right answer. You get all of them correct, and you win. Yep, you win. Tonight, we got a grand prize of $10,000 up for the taking. How much of that money will you be making? Y'all know about points, right? Okay, you earn points by answering questions correctly. Sharing to social from the HQ app. Those are the two ways. Yeah, points help you reach levels. Leveling up gives you free passes. A free pass lets you get a question wrong and stay in the game. The higher your level, the more free passes you have, and you can climb all the way up to level 10, babies. If you hit level 10, that means you only have to answer a couple questions correct to win HQ Trivia for the entire season. For every point earned by H Quizzes, the prize is going to keep on building and building and building till the season finale at the end of February. And this season, we're giving out more money than we did last season. Let's check in on that prize. Whoa, mama! $75,000 and $12 at the end. $75,012. That's a whole lot of money. Whoo! Okay. Who knows just how high it's gonna go? You're gonna want an extra life, all right? And an eraser. Extra lives keep you in the game after you get a question wrong, but you can only use them up until the last question. You can't use it on the last round. You can buy one now if you see it on your screen. Also, erasers eliminate one of the wrong answers, giving you a 50-50 chance of getting it right. And again, you can't use them on the final round, okay? Cool. Now, Valentine's Day is this week, and that means y'all better get your plans set for the big night. Yeah, we're celebrating all week long, babies. Tomorrow night, from Bridget Jones to Crazy Rich Asians. Don't miss movie trivia, okay? Movie trivia tomorrow night. The whole show is going to be about your favorite rom-coms. You need some tissues, some love letters, a body pillow sprayed with the cologne of someone you love. Because it's going to be 12 questions, just all about rom-coms. And then on Valentine's Day proper, put on your Manolo Blahniks and grab a Cosmo, okay? It's happening. We're doing Sex in the City trivia, babies. Are you a Carrie, Samantha, a Charlotte, or a Miranda? Find out this Thursday at 9 p.m., do not miss it, y'all. All right, y'all ready to start this game off, H Quizzes?
David.
Nothing to it but to HQ it. Here we go with question number one. Who is the musical artist featured in this video?
Help from the other side. I must have called 1,000 times.
Okay, is it Christina Aguilera, Adele, or Janet Jackson?
Hello from the other side. I must have called.
Who's it gonna be? All right, I'll give you a little hint. There is a boiling tea kettle in there. So, it's gotta be none other than the very British Adele, y'all. Yeah, also shout out to a 2015 video that features a flip phone. 388,265 are moving on to question number two. But before that, have you heard the word?
Hello, word nerds!
Yeah, we got a live game show. It's new. It's called HQ Words. That's where you solve word puzzles to win cash. If you know how to spell, you know how to win. So come out and play and win some money. Words is coming up next, right after HQ Trivia. So stick around. It's hosted by the word nerd herself, Anna Roisman. Want to try it out? Tap that button right now. Just tap it right now. Go ahead, get your tap on and subscribe. Word up. Cool. Question number two. What is the name of this song?
make this here with all the ice on in the booth. At the gate outside, when they pull up, they give me loose.
The name of the song. And
it's something new. If you don't know the words, you just mumble it. And it's something new.
Okay, is it Hey Jude, Sicko Mode, or Baby Shark?
Yeah, that's why I said the name of the song.
Who's it gonna be, y'all? I'm gonna give you a little hinty hint, okay? Travis Scott just performed this at the Super Bowl. And I think we can all agree, could've used a little more SpongeBob. This song is nominated for 2 Grammys tonight. Best of luck to you, Mr. Kylie Jenner. With
you. Yeah, gone on you with the pick and roll. Younger Flame, he in Sicko Mode.
Sicko Mode, baby! Yeah! Drake just said it, so I didn't have to. 370,848 got that one. You're moving on to question number 3. What now regular stunt did Pink premiere during her 2010 Grammys performance? Was it aerial gymnastics, fire juggling, or unicycle riding? She's doing it all the time now, but she debuted it in 2010.
Yeah, I fit it with that.
Feels like she's always flying around on those ropes now. But back in 2010, Pink won a Grammy for Best Pop Collab with Vocals. The same year, she debuted this routine. Have you ever held That's a hell of a wedgie. This should be a Charmin commercial. That's how strong a Nutrafly is. Just holding up soggy Pink. Yeah. Aerial gymnastics, y'all. 329,955. Y'all got that one right. It's time for question number 4. Here we go. This Ariana Grande song prominently samples from Ariana. What musical?
My neck is fuzzy. Make big deposits. My gloss is chopping.
Okay, is it Hamilton, The Phantom of the Opera, or The Sound of Music? Let y'all figure this one out. I'm surprised Soulja Boy wasn't an option here. This right here is my swag. Okay, good artists borrow, great artists steal, including my favorite things from Rodgers and Hammerstein's The Sound of Music. Listen.
With tattoos, who like getting in trouble? Lashes and diamonds, ATM machines. Buy myself all of my favorite things.
Money, Jim Penner. Okay. Ariana's nominated tonight, and she just dropped another album on Friday. But she's not at the Grammys, just like me. 199,966 of you got that right. The Sound of Music was the answer there. It's time for question 5. Here we go. What song did Lady Gaga perform at the Grammys when she came out of this egg? Was it Bad Romance, Just Dance, or Born This Way? She was all up in the egg, doing some Game of Thrones business, I guess. I don't know. I thought she was going to come out like a dragon or something, but she didn't. I would have been ready for that. Gaga told Jay Leno she spent 3 whole days in that egg. That just can't be true. You know what I'm saying? That's a long time to be in an egg. But the egg was definitely thematically appropriate because she emerged from it to sing Born This Way.
Just put your paws on, because you were born this way, baby.
What came first, the Gaga or the egg? The Gaga did, obviously. 301,892 of you just got that one. Congratulations to you, babies. It's time for question number 6, y'all. Snake imagery features prominently in the video for which Taylor Swift song? Bad Blood, Look What You Made Me Do, or Blank Space? What's it gonna be with all the snake imagery? Woo-woo!
What'd you go with, David?
All right, what do you do if someone calls you a snake? One option is to go all in on the snakes. Look What You Made Me Do. Put snakes in my video.
I got a list of names and yours is in red underlined.
Watch out, Taylor! Who's my fighter? Watch out, Taylor! Look What You Made Me Do, y'all. 186,717. Know what I mean? You're moving on to question number 7. Having fun. Grammy night. Trivia. Here we go.
Help me, Lynn.
Which of these 7-member K-pop groups is responsible for this song?
K-pop.
know that K-pop is Korean, right? You should. Continuing their incredible year, this group is presenting tonight at the Grammys. Oh, is it BTS, Icon, or GOT7? Yeah. I was just ready to read and talk to y'all. I didn't even say who the heck they was. That was my bad. It happens, you know. It's live. Things happen when you're live, babies. Okay. Continuing their incredible year, this group is presenting tonight at the Grammys, and they're also nominated. Yeah. AKA Bangtan Boys. It's worldwide phenomenon. BTS. Yeah.
That was
176,736. Are moving on to question number 8. Feeling great. Here we go. What concluded this Grammy's performance from Nicki Minaj?
So far ahead, these bums is lagging. See me in that new thing, bums is gagging. I'm starting to feel like a dungeon dragon. See, I feel pretty.
Communion, baptism, or exorcism? What's it gonna be? Communion, baptism, or exorcism? That was a very strange performance, but it was dope because it was Nicki Minaj. All right.
But it's probably
seen. In 2012, Nicki delivered us from evil, specifically boring performances, by staging a full-on exorcism.
Wow.
Thankful, joyful, and triumphant, I am Roman, so like the sky.
Not gonna lie. That was pretty creepy. 126,727 got exorcism right. You're moving on to question number 9, babies. Here we go. What Grammy Award did Jennifer Lopez win the year she wore this iconic dress? Oh, my goodness.
Anyone?
Looking like some fine Puerto Rican seaweed. Was it Best Dance Performance, Best Pop Performance, or No Award?
What's it? I just used it too.
All right. I mean, this is one of the great Grammy outfits, courtesy of Versace. And on this occasion, Jennifer was nominated for Best Dance Recording in Waiting for Tonight, but she was bested by Cher. Cher! No award, y'all. 86,461. I'm moving on to question number 10, my friends. Almost there. We got like 5 more questions to go till it's over. Here we go. Who won the first Grammy Award for Album of the Year in this millennium? Was it Radiohead, Mariah Carey, or Steely Dan? Who's it gonna be? It's one of the biggest Grammy upsets of all time. And no one's saying the winners didn't deserve Grammy, but against peak Eminem, huh? Midnight Vultures? Against Kid A? Steely Dan took them all down. Steely Dan. Whew. Steely Dan, y'all. 26,000. That's a savage question. Uh-oh. Here we go. Savage question song. Sorry you got it, bro. Savage question song. That's a savage question song. Yeah. 26,978. I'm moving on to question number 11. All dogs go to heaven. Here we go. Where is the band behind this music video from? Real funky jam, y'all. Okay, are they from Australia,
they from?
Canada, or England?
Australia, what's it gonna Canada, be? Or England.
I mean, you might know them from being sampled by Rihanna. But the band name is Tame Impala. And even though actual Impalas are from Africa, Tame Impala are from Australia.
Australia
was the right answer, 29,348. What y'all trying to say?
If it weren't for Steely Dan, I'd say
Impalas in Africa is wild, huh? What? Huh, okay. Remember, HQ Words is coming up next, right after HQ Trivia. So keep your phone close, babies. All right? Here we go.
Chef?
Q12. What did this win a Grammy for? Music video, pop solo performance, or dance recording?
I would have guessed B.
What's it gonna be? Music video, pop solo performance, or dance recording? All right, Miss Britney Jean Spears hasn't really gotten her due from the Grammy voters, considering she's the most iconic pop star from, you know, the aughts. But She did win Best Dance Recording, her one and only Grammy for Toxic. 16,564 got that right. It's a shame, okay? Britney should have got some more awards. Britney. I'm rocking with you, Britney Spears. Okay, question number 13. Here we go.
Oh, 13.
What famous artistic work is this music video about to recreate?
Soprano C, we like to keep it on the high note. It's levels to it, you and I know.
Is it The Thinker, The Last Supper, or Madam X? Be humble. Sit down. Be humble. Sit down. Kendrick is on some kind of streak. He's got 8 Grammy nominations tonight, 7 for his work on the Black Panther soundtrack. He won a Pulitzer for his album Damn, which features his biggest hit, Humble, which in turn shows The Last Supper.
Humble, hold up, sit down. Be humble, hold up, sit down. Be humble, hold up.
I remember syrup sandwiches and grandma allowances. 15,830 got that one. You're moving on to question number 14, Jelly Beans. Here we go. Which musician from this Grammy-winning hit song has a hat company?
Yeah, it's just like the ocean under the moon. It's the same as the emotion that I get from you. You got the kind of love that can be so smooth. Yeah, give me your heart, make it real, or else forget about it.
Okay, is it Rob Thomas, Carlos Santana, or neither?
I would guess
take it all in. Is it just like the ocean? I'm not a moon. You're not a moon? What's that mean? Like, same as the emotion that I brought you here. Got the kind of loving that to play HQ here. Okay. He cleaned up. Was it Rob Thomas, Carlos Santana, or neither? He got like 8 awards in total that night, okay? And while that's not easy to learn how to play the guitar like Santana, you can at least wear one of his hats. Yep, Carlos Santana got a hat company, y'all. 14,380. Got it right. You're moving on to the final question. Question 15. Question 15. What does this mean? $10,000. That's enough to make you holler. Yeah, okay. Question 15, y'all. Here we go. This year's Grammy host wrote this song, subtitled, for what family member?
Imagine there was no tomorrow. Imagine that I couldn't see your face. There ain't no limit to my sorrow.
Oh, no.
Cause there is nothing that could feel this.
Okay, is it grandma, brother, or father? Grandma, brother, or father? This is for all the marbles. $10,000, guys. Here we go. This year's host is Alicia Keys. She's known for her hit songs about Girls on Fire and My Boo. Yeah, not to mention her 15 Grammy statues. She also wrote this song for a family member. It's Grandma Night here on HQ. Grandma is the answer. That's a savage question. We got 2,505 winners of HQ Trivia! Yeah. Woo! 2,505 winners, y'all. Jacqueline, you got almost $4. ZNC, you got almost $5 too. Rosie Olis. Chase. Trix Mom. Sigil. Dino22. Naheem. Congratulations, babies. Y'all did it. You did the damn thing. Chicken Wang on the string.